whiteboard for us this week.
142 pounds, Pat Cusick and Stephen Perez.
Tag team action to kick us off in a week in which we did see Mr. McMahon really draw a line in the sand and say to Ric Flair, you've got a choice. You can do it the easy way or you can do it the hard way, so to speak. And we'll talk more about it. We'll show you all the highlights of exactly how a very controversial business decision was handled this past week.
And have you ever seen so much emotion in Norfolk, Virginia this week at SmackDown when Ric Flair had to make that decision, had to decide whether or not he would leave the business, sell all of his stock, or do what's best for the company, which I guess is really one of the same, goes hand in hand. And I've never seen more emotion poured out in one building for one night for one man than I did in Norfolk this past Thursday on SmackDown.
That is PHAT, Fat Albert. Stephen Perez, I think, is realizing now that, yes, that is 8 3/8. Oh, my goodness, this young man is going to get quite an awakening here. Our opening contest of metal. Cool slacks there on Albert.
Well,
right out of the coach's collection.
He's a fashion flick. Always has been, always will be.
Look at this giant squid. Oh, my goodness.
Kate Kelly, I never quite understand this because he gets more dizzy than the guy he's tossing. At least the guy he's tossing gets to lay down.
Oh, my goodness. All the blood rushing to Perez's head.
Hey, Albert, we only have an hour.
Well, I think this ride is just about over. Maybe Perez will have to put another quarter in. Yeah, you see the effects on Albert as well. His equilibrium is all thrown off.
This was like me last Friday night. It was late, though. It was about two bells.
Oh, boy. Well, now the tag is made back in, and here comes Scotty. Wait a minute. And look at this great double team move. The improvements in tag team skill made each and every week by Scotty and Albert are amazing. It has been a real delight to see them improve each and every week. And I know it was great to see Ric Flair introduce that very emotional and moving piece of footage, the history of the World Wrestling Federation, so to speak. We will see it later on. It brought a tear to an eye, certainly this past week on Raw.
Yeah, and if you were in the building, if you were lucky enough to be in the building in Norfolk and see, like you said, the emotion in that piece and the emotion from Ric Flair as we head towards WrestleMania, I can't remember a time, KK, since I've been here, certainly, that there's been so much at stake, so much emotion, so much riding on certain decisions and certain important decisions here in the WWF.
Albert showing the strength now. Pat Cusick, who's... he doesn't look like a slouch in there. He looks like a pretty well-put-together guy. Let's see what he can do here. Well, not much. Now a cover. Is it enough? Two count only. A lot of emotion as well from Stephanie McMahon Helmsley and Triple H.
Great.
We got to talk about that throughout the hour. Stephanie costing her husband a matchup for Booker T on Raw.
I'm so pleased that she's finally getting hers.
Well, I don't know about that.
It's
a
power trip. It always has been whining, you know, complaining. Realizing what we all knew all along.
We'll talk more about it later on. Tag team titles up for grabs here in the hour as well. Taz and Spike Dudley to defend the gold. And now, it is everybody's favorite four-letter word. Down into the chest. Although Perez rolls out of the way, Cusick is still in there.
Uh-oh.
Things are not looking good for one Pat Cusick.
Now it's everybody's favorite two-letter word. Or two-word word. Word.
Word! Oh, what a victory! As we mentioned, the tag team titles are